This video lecture is basically developed to give you a proof that the name of an array actually represents the address of the zeroth element of the array. Prior to watching this demo, you are requested to watch the theoretical explanation preceding this particular video. Only when you watch the theoretical explanation, please do come to watch the demo to have a complete clarity on the concept of arrays and pointers. So here what I have done is I have declared a small program int main void. What I try to do is I try to introduce small new things in every program so that your knowledge begins to gradually grow. Void in main indicates that suppose I had written my own function int sum. So sum can accept two parameters x and y. Or sum may refuse to accept any parameters, then I'll say int sum void. Just as sum is my user-defined function, main is also a function created by me, and I'm clearly telling that it is not going to accept any parameters from the user. So let's start with the code. I have declared an array of integers a of 5 with the values 99, 88, 77, 66, and 55. Then I have declared a normal integer variable b with the value 10. Now, if I just try to print b, 100% it's going to print 10. What we shall do is let us try to print a and see what happens. Alright, if you look at this particular piece of code here, alright, you have got an actual warning here. Okay, on this particular line, you have got an warning. So what is that line here? It is line 9 here. Here it is given me a warning. What it is trying to tell me here is, let's take a look at the warning. It's trying to tell me this particular a is a pointer to an integer type of data. That means it is an address. It is not a number. That's why it is telling me that there's a warning here on this particular line 9. So what I shall do is, in order to get rid of that, let me take this off. But before going to execute the program, I need to explain a few things. When I print b, it's straight away going to print the content in b, which happens to be 10. But when I try to print a, should it print a of 0, a of 1, or what it should print? So it prints something this big. Now this, if you have taken a look in the past, is nothing but it's an address of a location. So this clearly tells me that when I print the name of a, it is going to print the address of the zeroth element of the array. How do you prove that? We can do it something like this. We can say address of a of 0. Alright. And here what I can do is, just to see that it's printing the address, I am going to say unsigned long. Now if my theory is correct, a and address of a of 0 should both print the same values. So this will tell me that the name of the array is nothing but it is equal to the address of the zeroth element of the array. Let's try to run and see whether what I told really makes sense. So b has printed 10 as it is, and if you look at the address of the zeroth element, it is 2816. The address of array a is also 2816. This clearly indicates that the name of the array represents the address of the zeroth element of the array. I hope this clarifies your understanding of the strong relationship between arrays and pointers. Now, just to let you know, this a represents an address which is a constant type of address. What do you mean by constant address? It refers to a fixed location. I can't change the address of a from 2816 to 2820 or 284 and so on, because a always will refer to an address 2816 in the case of this particular program.